All of the studies on human embryo development has been possible because of the human revolution that was initiated in 1969 by the first in vitro fertilization of the human egg that happened here at the University of Cambridge, in fact in the building we are right now having our lab, by Bob Edwards' group. And this study showed that we can fertilize human egg and that we can then culture it for the first 6 days of development, so-called pre-implantation development, which is extremely useful for many reasons. The next stage of development, so-called black box of development, was not possible to get into because that's the time when embryo implants within the body of the mother and therefore we lose the touch of it, we lose the sight of it, we can't observe it directly. And we were not able to mimic this stage of development in vitro. So we can culture pre-implantation mouse or human eggs, which is for human 6 days of development, for mouse 4th day of development. They are cultured in a strictly chemically simple defined medium, but there was no platform or medium that embryos would survive in beyond that stage of development. So what we have done now, the development that we established here in our lab was to establish the platform and the environment, medium, in which we can culture those human eggs for the extra 6-7 days. We right now film development of embryos to have a dynamic picture how different types of cells segregate and establish their fate. Why it is important to understand this particular stage of development? So first of all, because it was never understood before, we did not have a very good idea how it happens. In fact, to a certain extent, we didn't have at all idea how it happens. And when I teach my students on the course, I often teach them with my colleagues who teach them about fruit flies or frogs, and this is unbelievable how much more we know about these other model systems, and students are often shocked how very little we know about ourselves and our own first steps in life. So that's one reason, just curiosity. But it's not just curiosity, because this is also the stage of development that many pregnancies fail. So to understand how embryos progress in its development through this period will help us with time to define ways to help embryo develop properly. It is like looking at the new planet, discovering new planet. You don't want to only discover it, you wish to understand the life on it. And really we are right now at that stage. So we open it up, we know it exists, and now we only know the beginning of what it is happening on that planet. And that's really going into it deeper and deeper and deeper. That's what excites me most.